Alright, so what is going on, everybody? Since Team of the Year is right around the corner, I thought I'd make a cool video showcasing my predictions for the Team of the Year. This is a combination of players that are pretty much obviously guaranteed a Team of the Year, players that I would like to see in the Team of the Year, opinions off of, like, the internet, Reddit, and all kinds of different sources, and also players that have Evos that I would like to see get upgrades as well. So, as you can see in my active lineups here, I have Offensive, Defensive, Community, and Young Guns Team of the Year. Let's start off with the Offensive Team of the Year. Just because it's in order. A lot of this is spans off of the points totals throughout the season. I pretty much looked at the top like 20 players and a lot of them are in here. Ovi, Stamkos, Kucherov, of course, they're probably all going to make Team of the Year. Now, for the second line, this is my current first line on my team. I am a Penguins fan. I would love to see an entire line of Pittsburgh Team of the Year cards. Malkin, of course, is going to get one. Kessel is more likely to get one than Crosby, I think, just because Crosby hasn't done as well as Malkin and Kessel this year. But since Crosby has the name behind him and he's just known for being one of the best players, I think he might ensure a slot into the Team of the Year for that reason. For the third line, Marchand, Goudreau, and Giroux. Giroux's fourth in points. Goudreau's having a good year. Marchand's having a good year. They're all doing well points-wise. And then Wheeler, McKinnon, and Hall. Hall's been on a tear recently. McKinnon went on a huge point streak, and he's just been having an awesome year. And then Wheeler is kind of situating himself in the top 10 in points. He could make Defensive Team of the Year, but I have him in Offensive Team of the Year right now because he is doing really well points-wise. So these are the forwards. For the Defensive Team of the Year, I've basically taken the top producing defensemen in the league. Carlson, Klingberg, Subban, I think, are 1, 2, 3. And I think these six guys are leading the NHL for points for defensemen. So kind of sucks that I have a lot of right D. I have 5 of the 6 of them are right D, but we'll see what EA decides to do when they actually release the Team of the Year. And for the goalies, I have Bobrovsky and Vasilevsky. Hoping Bobrovsky gets a Team of the Year. He hasn't been doing as well as other years, but he's still really good. The thing that separates him from other goalies is that he basically plays every game. Like, he plays a lot. And obviously, Vasilevsky is just doing the best out of every goalie in the league, so I feel like that's why he's going to be there. So that's Offensive Team of the Year. Let's move on to Defensive Team of the Year quickly here. And this one's a little bit harder because last year there were players like Gudas, Tanner Pearson, Mikko Koivu who aren't even, like, I have not even heard them do anything this year. So I don't think they're even going to make Team of the Year this year for Defensive Team of the Year. There were a few standouts like Bergeron, of course, is going to make Defensive Team of the Year. Not doing as well enough to make offensive for points, but he's just going to make Defensive Team of the Year. Ben's been having an awesome defensive year as well. A couple Defensive Team of the Weeks. Matthew Tkachuk, he was Defensive Team of the Year last year. I don't know if he's kept up the pace this year, but I have him there anyways. A large portion of this Defensive Team of the Year prediction spans off of opinions online of who will get what. Couturier is doing really well this year defensively. Mark Stone has won Defensive Team of the Year twice in a row. Kopitar's having an amazing defensive year. Riley Smith, Marchessault, and Carlson are currently the top 3 plus minus skaters in the entire league. So it'd be cool to see a three Las Vegas Defensive Team of the Year players here. I don't know if it's going to happen. William Carlson for sure, but maybe not Riley Smith. Who knows? And then Barkov, of course. And then for the fourth line, Dustin Brown was doing really well early on in the season defensively. He's 12th in plus minus right now. He's doing well otherwise. He could be there. I don't know. And then Melker Carlson, San Jose have the number one penalty kill in the league. And I think he's on their number one penalty kill line. So that's why I put him there because who knows, maybe he'll get one. For defensive here, Hedman, he was just sitting outside the top 6 for offensive defensemen. So that's why I slotted him into defense. I think he's I think he's leading the league in defensive plus minus, I think it is. I don't know. Roman Josi, not enough to make Offensive Team of the Year, so that's why I put him here. Same with Suter and Doughty. They're just both really good defensive defensemen. And then for the last, Vlasic's been having an amazing year in San Jose. And Chris Russell leads the league in shot blocks, so maybe he'll find his way into the Defensive Team of the Year. For the goalies, now I know Rask is Community Team of the Year, but the Community Team of the Year goalies, I don't know why they put Fleury, Rask, Bishop, and Lundqvist. in the slots, so I don't know what the point of that was. All four of those goalies deserve to be Team of the Year, so I don't know why they've separated them. Either Rask, Fleury, or Bishop just are not going to get a Team of the Year, so Bishop's going to win by popularity, I think, and then that means that Rask or Fleury won't get a Team of the Year, so I don't know why that they're doing that. Maybe if one of them doesn't get Team of the Year, they'll slot them in here, so for my sake, I've put Rask here in Defensive Team of the Year goalie, and then Rene to back him up as well, because Rene's having a really good year. Now, moving on to Community Team of the Year. These are just my picks off of the ones that they went and showcased for us to pick. I don't really agree with some of them because, like, for example, Clayton Keller, he's like a shoo-in for Young Guns Team of the Year, and he can't be Young Guns Team of the Year if he's on Community Team of the Year. I put him on my Young Guns Team of the Year just because I feel that he should be there, but we'll see what happens. For this one, though, these are all picks. So, for the first option, it was center. I picked Getzlaf, Monahan, Thornton, and Horvat. They all have Evos. That's basically the only reason why I picked them. I feel like Thornton might get a popularity vote because he's just... he might not get his milestone cards because he's been injured, so maybe people want him to get Team of the Year, so his card will go up. Apart from that, next up, I think, was the left wingers? I don't even know who it was, but I'm just going to go with right wingers. So it was Tarasenko, Hoffman, Forsberg, and Connor. Surprised that Tarasenko was there. He's obviously going to make Community Team of the Year because people will want his Evo to go up. Hoffman, I just like as a player in general. That's why I have him there. Philip Forsberg has an Evo, and that's why I put him there. I think he's going to get it as well. And Kyle Connor's been having a really good year, so I feel like, despite that Community Team of the Year, a lot of the players aren't deserving of one. I think Kyle Connor is one of the players that is deserving of a Team of the Year. So that's why I slotted him there. And then, of course, Pasternak. I have his Evo. I hope he gets a Team of the Year, so it'll go up. Panarin and Dadonov and Mantha. With the right wingers, I think it was, there were so many options that it basically comes down to, like, if you have a favorite team, you're going to pick that guy. That's basically all Community Team of the Year was. Like, Zibanejad, Zuccarello, Kevin Hayes. Like, a lot of these guys just, they don't deserve to be in a Team of the Year. And they were just there, I don't know why. But that concludes the forwards. Moving on to the defense, we have Chara was an option. If you don't choose Chara, like, what are you doing? 99 Chara could potentially be on the table. It kind of sucks that I have his 94 and it'll be useless if he gets a Team of the Year, but a 99 Chara will be the best card in the game. I mean, you have to vote for him. Ryan Ellis, I just voted for him because I like him as a defenseman. Justin Schultz, I voted for him because I like to see him get a Team of the Year for Pittsburgh. He's not having a good year, but he could make Team of the Year. I don't know. Varinsky, I have his Evo on two accounts. I have it on my play-to-win account, so I severely hope he gets a Team of the Year. And then Will Butcher, he could make Young Guns, but I just slotted him in there because I think people might vote for him to see him get a Team of the Year. And Ekblad, I just like Ekblad as a defenseman, so that's why I have him there as well. And for the goaltendings, these are the two options I chose. I left out Rask because I feel like he's more deserving of a Defensive Team of the Year or Offensive Team of the Year. And I feel like I'd like to see these two defense or goalies get Team of the Years. Now, lastly, Young Guns Team of the Year. This has been controversial, kind of, because people don't really know what the players' credentials are to get Team of the Year. For my Team of the Year, I basically just made it a bunch of young players that I feel should be in Young Guns Team of the Year. I just left out the whole entry-level contract thing or age difference, whatever. I just added a bunch of young players onto the team that I think might make Young Guns Team of the Year. First line you're seeing here, Laine, McDavid, and Clayton Keller. Clayton Keller is in Community Team of the Year. I have put him here anyways because I feel like he should be in Young Guns Team of the Year and not Community Team of the Year. McDavid obviously is going to get a Team of the Year, whether it's offensive or Young Guns Team of the Year. We don't know yet. But Laine is also on a tear recently, so he might get. So he's definitely in a shoo-in for Team of the Year. Besser, Barzal, and Rantanen. These two, the two best rookies of the year so far, they're guaranteed Team of the Year. Rantanen, he's just young. I slotted him in there because I feel like he has a chance. Larkin, he is a little bit older than some of the other guys. 21, actually. That's not old at all. He might actually be a shoo-in for Team of the Year as well. He's sure, just because he's having a pretty decent season and he was a number one overall pick, I feel like he deserves to be there. Marner, not doing so well. I basically put him in there because I really hope he gets some sort of Team of the Year because I have his Evo. And then the fourth line, Point's been doing amazing so far. Jesper Brad had a really good start to the season, and so did Kerfoot. And it was kind of hard finding really young guys, like young enough to be Young Guns Team of the Year. So a lot of these guys like Brad and Kerfoot, or even like Heischer, Keller, who are like not doing outstanding compared to everybody else in the league, they're still doing well as a rookie. Feel like they might get a chance to be a Team of the Year. And for the defensemen, these two are basically locked in already, McAvoy and Sergachev. Despite him being injured and despite Brock Besser being out for the rest of the season, I don't know if he's out for the rest of the season, actually. I think he might be just injured for a while. Those two are, despite their injuries, are guaranteed Team of the Years. Slavin, he was Defensive Team of the Year last year. Now he might also make Defensive Team of the Year this year or Rookie Team of the Year. Jacob Trouba, I think he's actually an option for Community Team of the Year as well, but I just put him in Young Guns Team of the Year because I feel like he's more deserving of a Young Guns card. And then Provorov and Nurse, who both are very likely to get Team of the Years. Provorov more over than Nurse, but still, despite that, I think that these defensemen are pretty deserving of this slot. Now for the goalies, the last bit of the video, Connor Hellebuck. I think he's like the youngest, I think he's basically pretty much a shoo-in for it. I can't really think of any other super young goalies. Maybe Vasilevsky, if they decide to slot him into Young Guns. And then Grubauer, I saw him on NHL.com. He was 7th in save percentage or something. And he's young, right? I think. 25. He's not young. Well, he might be kind of in his rookie season. I don't know if he's in his rookie season or if he's been playing for a while, but I slotted him in there because he was in my collection. And that's the whole team. So we'll see in the next coming weeks if my predictions are true. Let me know down below what you guys think of my predictions, what you guys think of the Team of the Year, what you guys think the Team of the Year will look like. I want to see some predictions down below. If you are new around here, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.